ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
కంటిన్యూషన్ టు ది లాస్ట్ క్లాస్. బ్లడ్ వెసల్స్, బ్లడ్ వెసల్స్. What kind of the blood vessels are present in the human body? What are the blood vessels means? Just assume. This is the artery. Arteries arises from heart. Definitely they may be emerges from heart. Definitely artery near the tissue divides into arteriole. This is the arteriole. Again, arterioles inside of the tissue is gets divides into capillaries. Inside of the tissue, that is divides into capillaries. This capillaries are principal sites for exchange of the material as well as exchange of O2 and CO2 between the blood and tissue. Capillaries can provide greater surface area for allowing the exchange of the O2 and CO2 between the blood and tissue, and for exchange of the nutrients and waste between the blood and tissue. Again, when we observe the diameter from artery to capillary is progressively decreases. Diameter from artery to capillary is progressively decreases. Means the diameter of artery is greater than diameter of arteriole. Diameter of arteriole is greater than diameter of capillary. Again, capillaries are connected with venules. These are said to be as the venules. Capillaries are communicated with venules. Again, venules are aggregated and form the veins. This venules are aggregated and form the veins. These are said to be as the veins. Diameter of the venule is less than veins. Diameter of the venules is less than veins. This veins again aggregate and finally form the caval vein. This is said to be as the caval veins. In that way, progressively from the venule to caval vein, diameter is gradually increases. From the venules to caval vein, diameter is gradually increases. In that way, blood capillary network is present in our body. Then what is the structure of artery and what is the structure of veins? Definitely when we observe the structure of artery and vein, when we observe the structure of artery, when we observe the structure of artery, in artery wall, the outermost layer which is present, that is said to be as the tunica, media. Outermost wall is said to be as the tunica externa or Tunica Adventitia. This is the tunica externa or tunica adventitia. It is made up of the fibrous tissue. Definitely it is made up of the fibrous tissue. Below to that, middle layer which is present, that is said to be as the tunica media. That is said to be as the tunica media, that is middle layer, which is made up of the thick smooth muscle. Very thick smooth muscle. Tunica media is made up of the very thick smooth muscle in the case of the artery. Means because of due to the thick tunica media, artery wall is more thick when compared to the veins. Artery wall is more thick when compared to the vein. Below to that, whatever the innermost layer which is present, that is said to be as the tunica interna. This is made up of the simple squamous epithelium, that is said to be as the endothelium. Innermost layer which is present in the wall of the artery is said to be as the tunica interna. That is completely made up of the endothelium, that is the simple squamous epithelium. Between the tunica externa and tunica media, between the tunica externa and tunica media, whatever the elastic membrane which is present, this is the outer elastic lamina. Similarly, between the tunica media and the tunica interna also, whatever the elastic membrane which is present, that is said to be as the inner elastic lamina. This is said to be as the inner elastic lamina. Means in the artery wall, between the tunica externa and the tunica media, outer elastic lamina is present. Between the tunica media and the tunica interna, inner elastic lamina is present. Again, when we observe the vein wall, when we observe the wall of the vein, here also, this is the tunica externa. Outermost layer which is present in the wall of the vein is also tunica externa or tunica adventitia, that is made up of the fibrous tissue. Here also middle layer which is present, that is said to be as the tunica media. Tunica media of the veins is less thick when compared to the artery. Tunica media which is present in the artery is with more thick, because in the tunica media of artery, very thick smooth muscle is present. But in the vein, tunica media of vein is less thick, because it is with thin smooth muscle. In veins wall, tunica media is with thin smooth muscle. Below to that kind of the tunica media, innermost layer which is present, that is said to be as the tunica interna. That is principally made up of the endothelium. This tunica interna here also is made up of the endothelium. This endothelium is enfolded to get some form the valves. In the case of the vein, tunica interna is gets infolded to gets form the valves. These are said to be as the valves. These are said to be as the valves. They directed towards the heart. This valves always directed to the heart. Means they may be allows the flow of the blood towards the heart from the body parts. Valves always allows the flow of the blood from the body parts towards the heart only. Again in the veins, between the tunica media and the tunica interna, single elastic membrane is present. That is said to be as the inner elastic lamina only. In the case of the veins, outer elastic lamina is not present like that of the artery. Outer elastic lamina is not present in the vein. Only inner elastic lamina is present. Sir, happened. Inner elastic lamina is present. So definitely in the veins, between the tunica media and the tunica interna, whatever the elastic membrane which is present, that is the inner elastic lamina. Means like that of the artery, two elastic laminas are not present. Like that of the artery, outer elastic lamina is not present in the vein. Only inner elastic lamina is present. Only inner elastic lamina is present, outer elastic lamina is absent in the vein. Again, endothelium shows the inward folding to form the valves. These are said to be as the valves. Endothelium of the vein is infolded to gets form the valve. That valves are directed towards the heart, because through the veins, deoxygenated blood is pumped towards the heart. Deoxygenated blood is pumped towards the heart. So that only to prevent the reverse flow of the blood from the heart towards the legs, to pump the blood from the leg to the heart. Definitely always veins carries deoxygenated blood from the body parts towards the heart. To gets allow the circulation of the blood from lower region to the heart, this valves are useful. They prevent the reverse flow of the blood. Definitely they may be directed towards the heart like this. Just assume this is the blood vessel like this. They may be directed towards the heart. They may be allow the circulation of the blood towards the heart. So, principal differences between the artery and the vein. Arteries are with both outer and inner elastic lamina, but veins are with only inner elastic lamina. In artery, tunica media with smooth muscle is more thick, it's very thick, but in the case of the veins, tunica media is less thick when compared to the artery. Then what are the principal differences between the arteries and the veins? Means what are the principal differences between the arteries and the vein? Means first, arteries, next veins. Next to veins, definitely arteries always carries oxygenated blood to the various parts of the body from the heart. Arteries always carries oxygenated blood from the heart to the body parts except pulmonary artery. Though in all kind of the arteries oxygenated blood is circulated, in pulmonary artery deoxygenated blood is circulated. That is exception. So first point, arteries carries oxygenated blood from heart to body parts. Heart to body parts, all kinds of the arteries always pump oxygenated blood from the heart to body parts except pulmonary artery. Pulmonary arteries are with deoxygenated blood. That is exception. Except pulmonary arteries, that is exception. In pulmonary artery deoxygenated blood is circulated. Again, in the case of the veins, veins carries deoxygenated blood from body parts to heart. Definitely veins always carries deoxygenated blood from the various body parts to the heart. Though all kind of the veins are with deoxygenated blood, but pulmonary veins are with oxygenated blood. That is exception. Though in all kind of the veins deoxygenated blood is circulated, but in pulmonary veins oxygenated blood is circulated. Except pulmonary veins, except pulmonary veins. Second one, artery walls tunica media which is present, that is with the thick smooth muscle. So that only definitely artery walls are more thick with thick tunica media. With thick tunica media, artery walls are more thick with tunica media, thick tunica media. Veins walls are less thick with thin tunica media. Definitely veins walls are less thick with thin tunica media. Again, diameter is narrow. Due to the thick wall, lumen is narrow. Diameter of artery is narrow, but diameter is wider. diameter of the veins is wider. Diameter is wider. Definitely veins lumen is wider because walls are thin. Diameter is wider. These are non-valvular. Definitely these are non-valvular. These are non-valvular means valves are not present. But these are valvular. Valves are present. Then where this kind of the arteries are located, where that kind of the arteries are located means arteries are located. Where this kind of the arteries are located, where this kind of the veins are located means these are deeply seated. Arteries are gets located in deeper part of the body. They are deeply seated. These are superficial. Definitely veins are located in the peripheral region of the body. Veins are located in peripheral region of body, but arteries are located deeper part of the body. Blood flows in jerky way with high pressure. Definitely in the case of the artery, blood is circulated very fastly. That is said to be as the jerk. That is the jerky way with high pressure. But in the case of the veins, blood is circulated with low pressure. Blood flows as steady and with low pressure. With low pressure, steady means stepwise, very slowly stepwise. If this blood is circulated, then we can say that is the steady. Definitely in the case of the veins, blood is circulated as steady way. Steady means slow and stepwise. If it is circulated as the stepwise, then it is said to be as the steady with low pressure, that kind of the blood is circulated. So what are the differences between the arteries and veins means? Arteries carries oxygenated blood from the heart to body parts. Though in all kind of the arteries, oxygenated blood is circulated, but in the pulmonary artery, deoxygenated blood is circulated. Veins carries deoxygenated blood from the body parts to the heart. Though in all kind of the vein, deoxygenated blood is circulated. Exception is in pulmonary veins, oxygenated blood is circulated. Second, artery walls are more thick with thick tunica media. Veins walls are less thick with thin tunica media. Diameter is narrow in the artery. Diameter is wider in the vein. These are without wall. These are with valves. These are deeply seated in the body. Means they located in the deeper part of the body. Veins are located in the superficial, that is the peripheral region of the body. Blood flows in the arteries is with very fast. That is said to be as the jerky. Blood is circulated in the artery very fastly, that is said to be as the in jerky way with the high pressure. In the case of the veins, blood flows very slowly, that is as stepwise, that is said to be as the steady with the low pressure. These are the differences between the arteries and veins. Again, definitely when we observe the structure of capillary, when we observe the structure of capillary, when we observe the structure of blood capillary, blood capillaries, so this blood capillary is with a single layer without muscle. The wall of the blood capillary is with only endothelium, simple squamous epithelium is present in the wall of the capillary, blood capillary. This fibrous tissue is not present, muscle tissue is not present. Means tunica, externa tunica, medias are not present in the wall of the blood capillary. Simple squamous epithelium is only present as the endothelium. This is said to be as the endothelium. So that only this blood capillary wall is very thin. So that only this allows the exchange of the O2 and CO2 between the blood and tissue, exchange of the nutrients and waste between the blood and tissue. So definitely in the case of the capillary wall, whatever the microscopic openings which are present, such microscopic openings are said to be as the fenestra. These are said to be as the fenestra. These fenestras are responsible for allowing the diffusion of the O2 and nutrients to out from the blood and allowing the diffusion of the CO2 and waste into the blood. In that way, blood capillary wall is very thin with only endothelium, without muscle, without fibrous connective tissue. Next, certain type of the two big blood vessel wall, just assume this is the big blood vessel wall, that is said to be as the aorta. Just assume this is the big blood vessel wall, this is the aorta. To the wall of the blood vessel, to the wall of the blood vessel, to supply the blood, microscopic vessels are innervated. To supply the blood to the wall of the blood vessel, big blood vessel such as the aorta, small blood capillaries, small blood vessels which may be innervated into them, that kind of the small blood vessels are said to be as the vessels of vessel or vasovasaram. Small blood vessels which may be innervated to the wall of the big blood vessel to supply the blood, that is said to be as the vessels of vessel or vasovasaram. These are the small blood vessels which may be supply the blood to the wall of the big blood vessel, that is the vasovasaram. Next topic is disorders of circulatory system. Circulatory system diseases or disorders of disorders of
सर्क्युलेटरी सिस्टम. डिजीजेस आर डिसऑर्डर्स ऑफ सर्क्युलेटरी सिस्टम. What are the disorders which are associated to the circulatory system of the human beings? First one is the hypertension. Hypertension or high blood pressure. Hypertension or high blood pressure. What is the hypertension? What is the high blood pressure? Before going to that, at first we have to know what is the blood pressure. What is the blood pressure means? While blood is circulated within blood vessel, blood accepts a certain pressure onto the walls of blood vessel. Such pressure is said to be as the blood pressure. While the blood is circulated within the blood vessel, that blood accepts certain pressure onto the both sides of the walls of the blood vessel. That is said to be as the blood pressure. So definitely, normal BP, normal blood pressure of healthy person is 120 by 80. mmHg is the normal blood pressure. In the healthy person, normal blood pressure is about 120 by 80. This is the systolic pressure or pumping pressure. That is said to be as the systolic pressure or pumping pressure. Means systolic nothing but whenever ventricles are in complete contraction, during that how much pressure is exerted on the walls of the blood vessel by blood is said to be as the systolic pressure. Whenever ventricle, specifically ventricles are in contraction, whenever the ventricles, both sets of the ventricles are in contraction, then how much pressure is exerted onto the wall of the blood vessel by blood is said to be as the systolic pressure or the pumping pressure. That is approximately 120 mmHg. 80 represent diastolic pressure or resting. This is the resting pressure. Means whenever the ventricles are in relaxation, during that how much pressure is exerted onto the wall of the blood vessel by blood is said to be as the diastolic pressure. So in the case of the normal healthy person, this blood pressure is about 120 by 80. So then how we can measure this kind of the blood pressure means by using sphygmomanometer, by treating branchial artery. This is the branchial artery of left hand. So by using the branchial artery, definitely we may be measure that kind of the blood pressure. By using the branchial artery means here this is the branchial artery. Definitely we may be measure that kind of the blood pressure by using this sphygmomanometer. Instead of 120 by 80, if this blood pressure is raises to 140 by 90, then that is said to be as the hypertension or high blood pressure. Instead of 120/80, if pressure is raises to 140/80, 140/90, means systolic pressure is raises to 140, diastolic pressure if it is raises to 90, then that is said to be as the hypertension or high blood pressure. So with this high blood pressure, vital organs such as the brain, such as the kidneys, are severely affected. Definitely, if a person is subjected to the hypertension or high blood pressure for longer period, what are the structures which may be, what are the vital organs which may be severely affected? Means brain, kidneys principally affected due to this kind of the hypertension for a longer period. So what is the reason for hypertension? Means the normal reason is, if we can ingest higher amount of the salt through the diet, that must be increases the blood pressure of the person. If we can ingest a higher amount of the salt through the diet, definitely that may be leads to the increased blood pressure. Then what is the drug which is more commonly used for the treating of the hypertension? Means that is the reserpin, which is collected from the Ravulfia vomitoria plant. Reserpin, which is commonly collected from the Ravulfia vomitoria plant, that is very commonly used for the treating of hypertension more effectively. Definitely, this is acts as hypotensive drug. This is acts as the hypotensive drug, means that mostly tries to decrease increased blood pressure. So that only that is principally acts as the hypotensive drug. So definitely, what are the reasons for hypertension? Means intake of the higher amount of the salt through the diet is the main reason. Definitely, this intake of the salt increases the blood pressure of the person. So that is leads to the hypertension. The more effective drug for the treating of the hypertension is nothing but reserpin drug. That is acts as the hypotensive drug. Again, very important to point, what is the pulse pressure? Here the question may be asked in NEET examination point of view. What is the pulse pressure? Pulse pressure is equal to systolic pressure minus diastolic pressure. Systolic pressure minus diastolic pressure, or pumping pressure minus resting pressure. The difference between the systolic pressure and the diastolic pressure is said to be as the pulse pressure. What is the pulse pressure of the normal blood pressured person? 120 minus 80, that equal to 40. What is the pulse pressure of normal blood pressured person? Means 120 minus 80, that equal to 40. What is the pulse pressure of hypertensive person? Hypertensive person means that is 50 mmHg, means 140 minus 90. So for example, pulse pressure of normal blood pressure person equal to pulse pressure of normal blood pressured person equal to 120 minus 80, that equal to 40 mmHg. Second question, pulse pressure of hypertensive person. Hypertensive person equal to 140 minus 90, that equal to 50 mmHg. Very important in the objective. Pulse pressure is equal to systolic pressure minus diastolic pressure. Definitely pulse pressure of the normal blood pressured person equal to 120 minus 80, that equal to 40 mmHg. Pulse pressure of hypertensive person equal to 140 minus 90, that equal to 50 mmHg. This is the hypertension or the high blood pressure, that is the first circulatory system disorder. Next, second type of the circulatory system disorder is coronary artery disease. Coronary